Hello everyone, this is Joanne. It's good to see you again here. Welcome back to our class. We are still learning about in the topic test reading part, but the good news is finally we are at the type 7 questions, and the type 7 question is the last type of question in the reading part of topic test. Type 7 question is, you can see type question number from 49 to 56 and 59 to 7. So there are 9 questions. So you can guess type 7 is much more difficult than the other questions, okay? So type 7 question, there is one passage and then you can read. After reading, you have 2 or 3 questions, and it will be the filling in the blank, or some finding, you know, correct thing or incorrect thing like that. Are you ready to start? All right, here we go. Number 1 to 2, you can read the passage and answer the question. 다음을 읽고 물음에 답하십시오. Here's in the passage, so you should read and then find out which is keyword and then what is story about. Okay? So I'm gonna read for you first. 제 친구는 그림 그리는 것을 좋아합니다. 그래서 시간이 있을 때마다 물통에 그림을 그립니다. 그리고 친한 사람들에게 물통을 선물합니다. 물통은 세상에 하나만 있습니다. 친구의 물통은 참 예쁩니다. We read the passage and you can see here in the blank. It will be the question. Maybe which sentence can go here or something like that. Alright. Let's summary for the passage. You should find which word, which keyword keep coming out, okay? 제 친구는 그림을 그리는 것을 좋아합니다. So we can find out main subject, right? Main subject can be 제 친구는. Can be subject. This is a story about my friend. Okay, my friend. 그림 그리는 것을 좋아합니다. This will be the main verb. So my friend like, right? My friends like, my friend like. Like what? Like what? 그림 그리는 것. 그림 그리는 것. Here's got. Can be some action, okay? 그림 그리는 행동, 행동. So 그림 그리는 것, drawing, right? Drawing, drawing. Can be drawing. So my friend likes drawing, right? My friend likes drawing. 그래서 is... Like in English, therefore, right? Therefore. Therefore always, you know, connect 2 sentences. First one can be the reason, and then the second is can be result, right? So my friend liked drawing, and so therefore, 시간이 있을 때마다 it can 물통에 그림을 그립니다. 그림을 그리다. Draw pictures. So my friend still, here's missing the subject, my friend still, okay, in here. My friend draws pictures. So draw picture, 물통에 can be some place, right? So my friend draw a picture at 물통. 물통 is the water bottle, right? Water bottle. My friend draw picture on the water bottle, okay? On the water bottle. when 시간이 있을 때마다, 마다, whenever. So this can be the time, right? When my friend draw a picture, whenever my friend has time. Okay, whenever my friend has time. 그리고, what is 그리고? And, that's right, and. 친한 사람들에게 물통을 선물합니다. So here still missing, you know, the subject is still missing, my friend. My friend 물통을 선물합니다. This is the verb, 선물합니다. Give a present. Give a present. My friend gave a present to whom? 누구누구에게 to whom? 내 친구에게. 아, no, no, no. 친한 사람들에게. Some close people. Friends, right? 무엇을? What? 물통을. 물통을. And here's in blank, 물통은. Here, new subject, right? New subject. 물통은 세상에 하나만 있습니다. 물통은 있습니다. There is a water bottle, right? There is a water bottle. But that water bottle, which is the only one in the world, right? 하나만, only one. 세상에서, 세상에, the world, right? 친구의 물통은, new subject, 친구의 물통. My friend's water bottle. But not normal water bottle, my friend's water bottle with a drawing, right? My friend's water bottle is 예쁩니다, is pretty. 참, pretty, pretty. Very, very pretty. 참, very pretty. Okay? Alright, let's make some summary. So this is a story about my friend. 내 친구. No way. My friend, right? My friend. What does my friend like? 그림 그리는 거, 그림 그리는 것을 좋아합니다. 좋아해요. 좋아하다. And then my friend, 어디다가? Where my friend draws on? Where does my friend draw on? 그림을 어디다가 그리냐면 물통에다가 그립니다. 그리다. 물통에다가 그려요. 그리고 물통을 선물해요. 선물합니다. 선물해요. 이 물통은 세상에 하나만 있어요. 세상에 하나. 친구의 물통은 어때요? How is the water bottle, my friend's water bottle? 예쁩니다. 예쁘다. 예뻐요. So this can be the summary. Okay. So we find out what the story about. Let's move. So there's two questions, right? Number one. 기억에 들어갈 알맞은 말을 고르십시오. Remember 기억? Here. 기억에 들어갈 알맞은 말을 찾아볼게요. Let's find which is the best. Which is the best in the blank, okay? Remember the sentence before blank. 친한 사람들에게 물통을 선물합니다. Then after blank. 물통은 세상에 하나만 있습니다. So, after the blank, the Where is 물통? 물통. So this is about 물통. What kind of 물통? Right? What about it? So 친구가 판. 친구가 판. 판 mean 팔다. 팔다. What is 팔다? Sale. Sale. Number two, 친구가 만든. What is 만든? 만들다. Make. Make. Made. 사람들이 가지고 간. 사람들이 가지고 간. People took. People took. The water bottle people took. 사람들이 만드는. The water bottle people are making. Or the water bottle people are making. So which is the best? This water bottle my friend made, right? My friend made and gave to people, right? Close people. So the best answer will be 친구가 만든. The water bottle, the water bottle my friend made, right? The water. Number two, 이 글의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. 같은 것, 같은 것 means same, similar. It means what is this story about? What is true? What is true about this passage? Okay? Number one, 친구는 물통으로 그림을 그립니다. 물통으로 그림을 그립니다. My friend draws picture, right? Draw picture, drawing. My friend is drawing on the water bottle, right? So my friend used water bottle for drawing, right? For drawing. 땡땡으로 can be, you know, the tool or some subject, okay? So, number one, I think it's true. Number two, 친구는 예쁜 물통을 받았습니다. 받았습니다 mean receive. Receive, okay? Receive. My friend received the water bottle, pretty water bottle. No, my friend gave to other people, right? Number three, B. Number three, 친구는 친한 사람들과 그림을 그립니다. My friend draws picture, right? Draws pictures. But we don't know the other close people, close friend draws together or not, right? Can be true. Number four, 친구는 물통에 예쁘게 그림을 그립니다. It can be true. 친구는 물통에 예쁘게 그림을 그립니다. My friend draw picture on the water bottle, right? On the 물통에. 물통에. So number one and four can be the answer, but the best answer will be number four. Number four. Okay, let's move next question. Number three and four. Here's passage. So let's read together. 몇십 년 후에는 자전거가 하늘로 다닐 것입니다. 그러면 그 자전거를 만드는 사람이 필요합니다. 그리고 하늘에 자전거가 있으면 하늘에서 일하는 사람들도 있어야 합니다. 지금은 이런 사람들을 블라블라 없습니다. 하지만 앞으로는 이런 사람들을 자주 볼 수 있을 것입니다. Alright. So, let's find what's keyword. 몇십 년 후에는 몇십 년 is year, right? It's about the time. Time. 몇십 년 후에 several years later, right? Several years later. 자전거가 하늘로 다닐 것입니다. 자전거 can be the subject. 자전거 is Bicycle, right? Bicycle. 하늘로 다닐 것입니다. 자전거가 다닐 것입니다. Is main verb. To where? 하늘로. To 하늘로. Right? So this is a story about the bicycle, we can guess. 그러면, and then, 그 자전거를 만드는 사람이 필요합니다. 그 자전거, 어떤 자전거? What kind of bicycle is? 하늘을 다니는 자전거. 자전거를 만드는 사람이 필요합니다. 사람이 필요합니다. The people, the person who makes the bicycle which can fly, needed, right? 필요합니다. 필요해요, need, right? Necessary. 그리고, and, 하늘에 자전거가 있으면, if, 땡땡 하면, 땡땡 있으면, 땡땡으면, if the bicycle is in the air, in the sky, 하늘에 자전거가 있으면, 하늘에서 일하는 사람도 있어야 합니다. 하늘에서 일하는 사람들, 어떤 사람들? 사람들, people. What kind of people? People who work at the sky, right? At the sky are also necessary, right? Have to be there, right? Have to be there. 지금은 now 이런 사람들을 땡땡 없습니다. 이런 사람들, 어떤 사람들? What kind of people are they? 하늘에서 일하는 사람들 없어요. Why? Why aren't there people who work at the sky now? Because we don't have There isn't the bicycle which can fly, right? 하지만, but 앞으로는, in the future, 이런 사람들을 자주 볼 수 있을 것입니다. 이런 사람들, who works in the air, 자주 볼 수 있을 것입니다. We can see these people more often in the future. So this is about future bicycle, right? Future bicycle. 자전거. 어떤 자전거? 하늘로 다니는 자전거. 그러면 이 자전거를 만드는 사람이 필요해요. 이 사람들은 바로 하늘에서 일하는 사람들. 지금은 이런 사람들 볼 수 없어요. 지금 이런 사람들 없어요. But 앞으로는 볼 수 있어요. Okay? Right, good. Do you understand about this passage? Let's move to the question. Question number 3. 기억에 들어갈 알맞은 말을 그리십시오. 기억 over there. 지금은 이런 사람들을 없습니다. 지금 이런 사람들 땡땡 없습니다. 지금은 이런 사람들을 number 1 만날 수 To meet. Number 2. 기다릴 수. To wait. To wait for. Number 3. 가르칠 수. To teach. Number 4. 보낼 수. To send. So, which can be the best? 지금은 이런 사람들 땡땡 없습니다. 하지만 would be but. But, change the subject, right? Change the subject. But, 앞으로는 이런 사람들 자주 볼 수 있습니다. 볼 수 있다. See, right? Which can be 만날 수. So there's no see, right? 볼 수 있다. 하지만 보다 has different meaning. 보다 we can see see or we can say meet. 내일 봐. To see you. See you tomorrow, right? But it means we can meet tomorrow, right? So, right answer for number one. Number four, 무엇에 대한 이야기인지 맞는 것을 고르십시오. Also, you can find which is the true about this passage. Number one, 미래의 자전거. 자전거. Number two, 미래의 생활. Number three, 내가 만든 자전거. Number four, 내가 좋아하는 자전거. Number one, 미래의. 미래 mean the future, right? Future. We can find out 앞으로는 mean in the future, right? So this kind of bicycle isn't now, right? In the world, but in the future, maybe someone invent new, some creative bicycle, right? So this is about 미래의 자전거. Number? No, one. Right, number one. Number two and three and four. Number two, 미래의 생활 means the life of future. It can be but more specific talk about bicycle, right? And number three, 내가 만든 자전거, the bicycle I made. This is not about made something or I made a bicycle. Number four, 내가 좋아하는 자전거, the bicycle I like. But this is not about my favorite bicycle or something like that. So right answer can be number one. Number five and six. Here's the passage. 저는 새벽에 일어나서 혼자 운동을 합니다. 운동을 하면 즐겁습니다. 그런데 새벽에 땡땡 일어나는 것이 힘들어서 가끔 운동을 못합니다. 그래서 다음 주부터는 밤에 언니와 같이 운동을 하기로 했습니다. 이제 매일 운동을 할 것 같습니다. Right, let's find out which words keep coming out. I can find out 운동 and 운동. There are so many 운동, the words 운동 in the passage. So we can get out this story is about 운동. What is it, 운동? Exercising, working out, right? Working out. 저는 새벽에 일어나서 혼자 운동을 합니다. What is the subject? 저는 나, I. What did I do? 운동을 합니다. Work out, right? I work out. When? 새벽에 일어나서. In the early morning, I woke up and work out alone, 혼자. 운동을 하면 즐겁습니다. 운동을 하면 I work out and feel happy, right? Feel great. 그런데, however, but, right, can be changed the subject, right? 새벽에 땡땡땡 일어나는 것이 힘들어서 가끔 운동을 못합니다. There's two sentences. 새벽에 일어나는 것이 힘들어서. 새벽에 일어나는 것이 힘들어요. 새벽에 일어나는 것이 힘들어요. The waking up in the early morning is so hard, difficult. 가끔 운동을 못 합니다. 못하다 운동 no exercise, no workout. I don't work out 가끔 sometimes when because it's hard to wake up in the early morning, so I skip the exercise. It's very I don't work out. 그래서 so therefore 다음 주부터는 밤에 언니와 같이 운동을 하기로 했습니다. 다음 주 This is about time. There are three words express of the time. 지난 이번 다음 last this and next, right? So 다음 next 주 week next week from next week from next week 밤에 언니와 같이 at night 밤에 언니와 같이 with my sister I 예를 들어 missing the subject I work out together I'm going to work out together with whom with my sister when at night from when from next week okay 이제 and now 이제 매일 every day 운동을 할 것 같습니다. I didn't do yet, right? I didn't do workout yet, but I guess I can do. I can work out. I guess I can work out every day from now, right? So this is about the working out 운동. 나는 운동을 해요. 언제? 새벽에. 하지만 운동을 하면 즐거워요. 하지만 새벽에 일어나는 거 힘들어요. 그래서 운동을 못 해요. 못 할 때가 있어요. 다음 주부터는 그래서 다음 주부터 언니와 함께 운동해요. 그럼 매일 할 수 있을 것 같아요. Okay? Alright, this is can be the summary and we can find the answer of the question. Number 5. 기억에 들어가 알맞은 말을 고르십시오. 기억. Alright, the second line. 그런데 새벽에 땡땡땡 일어나는 것이 힘들어서 자, look at here. So if there is no blank, 새벽에 일어나는 것이 힘들어서 it is a perfect sentence, right? It is a perfect sentence. It means It's not necessary, like a subject, verb, or object, right? So this can be adverb, right? Adverb. So there's all adverb, right? Number one, many, mean a lot, very. Number two, 잠깐, just a little bit, moment, 1 second. Number three, 늦게, late. Number four, 일찍. Early. So which can be the best? 새벽에 많이 일어나는 것이 많이 일어나는 것이 We cannot say this waking up is a lot, right? And 새벽에 잠깐 일어나는 거 Is it just waking up for a moment? No, right? Wake up after that working out, right? Number three, 늦게. 새벽에 늦게 일어나는 것 mean we oversleep and wake up late. It's very easy, right? Number four, 일찍 mean early. 새벽에 일찍 일어나는 것이 힘들어요. It is hard to wake up early, right? Early. So, right answer for the number four. Number six. 위 글의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. 같은 거 mean true. We can find true, right? We can find true. Number one, 이 사람은 저녁에 운동을 했습니다. Is it true? It keeps saying, I work out 새벽에, 새벽, it's early morning, early morning. It's not in the evening, right? And number two, 이 사람은 아침마다 언니를 만납니다. 아침마다 every morning. But this person is going to exercise, work out with sister from now, right? Not yet. They didn't meet yet. Number three, 이 사람은 언니와 운동을 할 것입니다. They are going to 뭐뭐 땡땡 할 것입니다. Mean be going to. So this person is going to work out with sister. Can be true. Number four, 이 사람은 언니와 약속을 하려고 합니다. This person is try to promise with sister. It can be true, right? Because they are going to work out together. But the best answer will be number three, right? Okay. Do you understand until here? It's a little bit complex question, so maybe it's a little bit difficult to answer the question. Number seven and eight. 다음을 읽고 물음에 답하십시오. 저는 모자가 여러 개 있습니다. 그래서 we can read and find out keyword together. 저는 모자가 여러 개 있습니다. 나에게는 I here 있습니다. Has two meaning, right? Have and there is. And here have. Okay? I have hats a lot, right? Hats. 여러 개. Mean we cannot count the amount, but I have so many, right? 이렇게. 그래서 therefore 그때 다른 모자를 씁니다. 그때 mean anytime I can wear different hat because I have a lot of hats, right? 사람을 처음 만날 때는 here they mean the time when, right? When I meet people at first time, 부드러운 느낌의 모자를 씁니다. 쓰다 has a different meaning, okay? 쓰다 has a right or wear or use, okay? So in here, used to wear, right? Wear. 모자를 씁니다. Wear hat. What kind of hat? 부드러운 느낌. 느낌 means in a kind of mood. So very nice and gentle. Okay, nice and gentle. 운동을 할 때는 when I work out, 운동을 할 때는 가벼운 모자를 씁니다. I wear a hat. What kind of hat? Light hat. 다음, blank. This can be the question. 멋있게 보이고 싶을 때는 언제? When I want to be very gorgeous, right? 유행하는 모자를 씁니다. I wear a hat. What kind of hat? 유행하는 모자? very trendy hat, right? Trendy hat. 이렇게 모자를 바꿔 쓰면 이렇게 mean 앞에서 나오는 different, you know, different way to wear a hat. 모자를 바꿔 쓰면 바꿔서 쓰면 so when I change to wear hats all the different time 기분이 좋아집니다. I feel better. 기분이 좋다. I feel better. I feel good. I feel good. So this is all about the 모자, right? 모자. So we can find out what thing can be 기억, right? But so 기억에 들어갈 말. So we can find out here connection word, right? And then you can look at here. I have a lot of hats, and every single time I can change to wear my hat. So this is about the detail. First, when I meet the people for effort, I can wear the hat, very gentle type of hat. And second, 운동을 할 때, and when I work out, I wear very light hats. And third, when I want to be very gorgeous, and I wear very trendy hat, right? So number one, two, three, all the same. So when you connect same meaning, I mean, connect the, you know, sentences, we can use and, right? And here's and in Korean, number three. Good. Number eight. 이 글의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. 같은 거. You can find the truth. Okay, you can find the truth. Number one, the truth. Number one, 저는 모자가 한 개 있습니다. Do I have only one hat? No, I say 여러 개. I have many hats, right? 여러 개 mean 많이, 많은. 저는 유행하는 모자가 있습니다. 유행하는 모자. I have very trendy hat, right? 유행하는 모자. When I wear trendy hat, when I want to be gorgeous, right? Number two can be true. Number three, 저는 운동을 할 때 모자를 안 씁니다. 안 씁니다 mean not, right? 안 씁니다. I don't wear a hat when I work out. When I work out, what did I say in the passage? What kind of hat do I wear? Very light hat, right? Number four. 저는 사람을 만날 때 모자를 벗습니다. 벗다, take off, right? Take off, put off. But when I meet people, I wear very gentle type of hat, right? So you cannot fit you. Right, answer is number two. So today, there's only one more. Okay, one more question. Alright. 라면은 맛있지만 소금이 많이 들어 있어서 건강에 나쁩니다. This is story about 라면. Do you know what is 라면 is? 라면 is nude. Very curvy nude. Very delicious. It's so delicious. Spicy and delicious. Noodles. 라면은 맛있지만, I mean, but, 땡땡지만, but. The 라면 is very delicious, but 소금이 많이 들어 있어서, 소금 is salt. 소금이 많이 들어 있어서, 많이 있어요. They're so salty. It is very salty. 건강에 나쁩니다. 그래서 건강에 나쁩니다. It's bad for health. It's bad for health. It's not healthy food, you mean, right?
라면의 소금은 보통 국물을 만드는 수프에 있습니다. 라면의 소금,
the salt of 라면 is in the soup.
수프에 있습니다. 수프는요, 라면이 있으면
sauce. It's like a sauce, okay, sauce. But this salt can make 국물, soup, right?
그래도 국물을 먹고 싶으면
if you still want to have soup,
이 수프를 조금만 넣습니다.
Just put a little bit, one zip, two zip, like that.
그리고 and 라면을 끓일 때
when you boil the ramen, when you cook the ramen noodle,
수프를 늦게 넣는 것도 소금을 덜 먹는 또 하나의 방법입니다. 또 하나의 방법
is the one way to
소금을 덜 먹는
to eat less salt,
덜 mean less
salt
is 수프를 늦게 넣는 것.
To put salt later.
Weird. Alright, anyway, if you don't want to have salt or salty food, you cannot eat the noodle, but that noodle is so delicious.
Delicioso,
really. Alright, there are so many blank. 기역, 니은, 디귿, 리을, okay? I can guess the question. This sentence where can go in between the different blank.
그래서 therefore this is the hint.
So something the
sentence before this can be written.
Okay, written. 그래서 소금을 적게 먹으려면
mean less. It's similar, dull.
소금을 적게 먹으려면 라면 국물을 먹지 않는 게 좋습니다.
I told you before, right? If you don't want have salt or you want less salt, the right answer is you don't have the soup, right?
라면 국물, the soup of 라면, 먹지 않는 것이,
not to have the soup is good, is better.
So this sentence can go something about salty ramen, you know, makes you eat salt a lot, right? And especially the salt is in the soup. So this sentence is about the soup of ramen, right?
Look at here.
This sentence. 라면의 소금은 보통 국물을 만드는 수프에 있습니다.
There is salt in the soup, right? But the soup is so delicious. So, if you want to have the soup, you can put a little less salt, right? 그래서 But here, if you want to have the soup, right? So it means, you can say, oh no, wait. 라면을 더, sentence can go here, right? Like, look at this. 라면의 소금은 보통 국물을 만드는 수프에 있습니다. 그래서 소금을 적게 먹으려면 라면 국물을 먹지 않는 것, No having, no eating, no eating is the best, right? But, 그래도, but if you want to have soup, want to have soup, you can put less salt, less salt. Right? So right answer is number two. Number 10, 이 글의 내용과 같은 거, you can find the truth. Number one, 라면은 건강에 좋은 음식? 좋은 음식, is it true? Is it good food? Good food for health? No, it's very not good for health because ramen had a lot of salt, right? B. Number two, 수프를 많이 넣으면 건강에 좋습니다. 수프 is a sauce. Is a sauce. The sauce has a lot of salt, so having salt a lot is not good for health, right? So this is can be true. 수프를 먼저 넣으면 소금을 많이 먹게 됩니다. It said, look at here. 수프를 늦게 넣는 것도 소금을 덜 먹는 또 하나의 방법이라고 했으니까 수프를 먼저 넣으면 먼저 and 늦게 had opposite word. 먼저는 first. 늦게는 later. Okay? Opposite word. So, 늦게 먼저 넣으면 소금을 많이 먹게 됩니다. It's true. Number four. 라면에 소금을 적게 먹는 방법은 한 가지입니다. It's not true. 소금을 조금 넣는 것. One way. 그리고 라면을 끓일 때 수프를 늦게 넣는 것. It's second way, and 국물을 먹지 않는 거, third way, right? So there are three ways, not only one way. 한 가지 아니에요, 세 가지예요. So right answer is number three. So type 7 question is very complex, and multiple question is finding right answer is a little bit difficult, but we keep practicing and practicing. It makes you have right answer very easily, okay? Alright, so, no way. So, today, that's all for today, okay? And then the next question we can try on next lesson, okay? Alright, thank you for listening and watching me today, and then see you next time. 감사합니다.